serikali, angalieni maneno ya wamama kwa makini, la sivyo hatutapiga kura.
The debate on how to fulfill gender parity in parliament continues to be a thorn in the flesh of various policymakers in the country. Of key importance is the very fact that parliament is staring at a Supreme Court deadline that is barely 3 months away. And at a time various suggestions have been flouted as regards women representation, the government's chief legal advisor, Professor Githu Muigai, wants the August deadline pushed further by 1 year. Professor Muigai, who spoke when he appeared before the Justice and Legal Affairs Committee, accompanied by his technical working group on gender parity, held a four-hour-long closed-door meeting over the best modalities of achieving gender parity. And while at disposal is a constitution amendment bill whose brainchild is the committee's chair, Samuel Chepkonga, Professor Muigai is calling for an additional time to converse on the emotive matter. While the committee is willing to accommodate Professor Muigai's proposal, its chair Samuel Chepkonga has declined to withdraw his bill, which seeks to have gender role achieved progressively.
We feel as women, if we lose it now, the factor that women have been put in a place where they can communicate to the world politically, we will never be able to achieve, because it was not easy to get what we have in the constitution today. In the likely event that we don't agree between now and the 27th of August 2015, we can still extend constitutionally. We still have 1 year allowance, which would take us now from the 27th of August this year to the 27th of August 2016.
Apart from Chepkonga's bill, two more bills have been forwarded for publishing by individual members. Narok County MP Soipan Tuya has proposed amendment to the constitution to have each county elect two women representatives.
Mine is a mix where we have two women representatives per county, and any gap thereafter, after the elections, should be filled up by nominations. The reason why we are doing this is because our electorate is not mature enough to view women as equal to men in elective positions, and that's the truth of the matter.
Women MPs have also used the opportunity to renew their push for affirmative fund, which they argue is vital for carrying out civic education among members of the public on why they need to elect women.
We need a lot of education of the masses, because I say this is a cultural problem, it's a socialization problem, and so we have to get to a point where we are doing a desocialization of the masses, desocializing our society to actually embrace women leadership and afford women equal opportunity.
As Kenyans, we must comply with the constitution. Whether it is an issue of gender, whether it is an issue of devolution, whether it's an issue of respect for human rights, we cannot discriminate when it comes to women. Something must be done, and it must be done very soon.
Kevin Washira, Channel One News.